You know, and that, there's always that thought of like if I'm a game company and I have a for surefire hit in my back pocket, maybe I just want to keep that shit in my back pocket until I need it.
And put that shit in the glass. You just break glass in case of emergency.
Who knows what could happen in the next year? I mean, Sony could lose $10 billion in sales. You know, we have no idea. You know, when they're like, "Oh shit, everyone's turning on us. Everyone's turning on us. They're hunting us down. They're not buying our shit. Oh, fuck it, Bloodborne.
Last of Us 3.
they gotta throw out a sacrificial lamb to the slaughter. Which currently, that target is falling on the back of Bungie, where Papa Sony decided we're going to spank them and say you need to be more accountable for your damage loss. I mean, your release date windows."
Damn.
Bruh.
That's wild.
I don't know, bro.
I mean, have we heard anything since they released that trailer for that game, though? We haven't heard shit from them.
That's the sad part.
The thing is, what are they doing?
What
are they doing aside from Destiny and Marathon, right? Like that they need to be accountable for release date windows. They've had to go back to the drawing board with Marathon. Yeah, no one cares about Marathon. We don't care about that. Yeah, they've had to take that back to the drawing board. So there's no, I mean, maybe Sony was banking on them releasing Marathon as a big hit. And so now they're just like, well, now that we don't have a hit in 2024, because Bungie has to push back Marathon,
that was supposed to be
we have
year.
Nothing. Yeah.
That might have, what they probably were banking on that game. Because keep in mind, they said that they don't have anything coming out till next year.
Yeah. So... Which investors went, the fuck you mean?
Yeah.
You don't have anything. Bruh, so
that
Sony's
like investors, they flop in, flop out like that. That happens. Like that's not as big of a deal as people are making it seem to be.
No,
like what they're flopping back in with the success of Helldivers. So you know what I mean. Like that's gonna happen.
Last of Us 3 something, PS5 Pro something. They'll be right back on board. So like that's not that big. People are going crazy over it. I'm like, y'all even know how this shit works?
They're gonna announce a Bloodborne remake on PS5 Pro bundle, and everyone's gonna be like, "Yeah, we're back."
Best experience.
We're so back.
Pro, you best believe I'm gonna buy a PS5 Pro for that game.
And that's the thing. Like, so, people are going to do it too. Like, people are absolutely going to buy it.
I'll buy two.
Here's a quote that Totoki was saying about Bungie, and I quote, "I visited the Bungie studios and had meetings with the management, and I saw that employees were working at the studios were highly motivated, showing great creativity, as well as an impressive knowledge of live services. However, I felt there was room for improvement from a business perspective with regard to areas such as the use of business expenses and assuming accountability for development timelines. I hope to continue the dialogue and come up with some good solutions." Damn.
Dude, accountability for development timelines is wild.
Bro, do you want to translate? Do you guys want to translate that shit from business speech to...
I noticed y'all motherfuckers are dropping the ball. You're not meeting your deadlines. Right, fucking pick that shit up or you're going to lose people again.
What I'm thinking right now.
I mean, I feel like Bungie hasn't been on the ball for a long time.
No, a very long time.
Like Destiny 2.
I don't even think they're worth,
hasn't
maybe they're
really
resting on their laurels.
When was the last time that we heard Destiny 2 and it was still relevant in like the gaming sphere? It was that like
last DLC?
Probably not the last DLC. I think it was the one where they were considered they were like a top nominee for like best community support in the Game Award, which was the year 2022, right? Yeah. Something like that.
That would have been, I think it was that. Yeah,
I think it was like the Last Light or some expansion that they dropped, which was like at that time. I think that's when they also started dropping updates like cross save and all kinds of stuff like syncing your saves and things like that, where I was considering potentially getting back into it if I could get my save back from Destiny 2. That was the last time it was anything relevant, and since then it's just been nothing, because I think they're still releasing. I think they still have like one last expansion coming out. I don't know if it came out already, but
It was delayed. It was set to release in February, but it's now delayed for June 4th of this year.
Okay. So that's, another shape. Delay. Yeah, the final shape. And then you have Marathon, because I have a feeling it's been delayed because they've moved majority of their team already to work on Marathon, and that got hit hard because everyone was just like, this sucks.
Oh, it had very influencers bad. Influencers were just Marathon, like, this is terrible. Marathon, Marathon had very bad press. I mean, even when we talked about it, we were like, What is this game trying to be like
funny enough that game is probably Helldivers. It's an extraction shooter, isn't that what they said it was? They're making Marathon supposed to be an extraction
like a
shooter,
tactical like extraction shooter, right? But it's a first person shooter as opposed to third person shooter, third person, right?
Yeah,
so it's Rainbow Six Extraction or whatever the fuck it was. Like, I personally don't understand this. Like, Sony, there was a time where there could be a trend in gaming and Sony would still kind of stick to their guns and the things that they were making, things that they were passionate about, right? Now it's like, it's the same thing that happened with, like, the Suicide Squad game, where we're seeing these fucking publishers just force out these bullshit, like, just cookie-cutter games, and it's like, nobody really wants an extraction shooter unless it comes out and it's like super good. But nobody I don't know anyone personally, or I haven't seen anyone that's like, yeah, man, I want a new extraction shooter, bro. That's what I want right now. Helldivers 2 came out and it's great, right? But nobody in the back of their head was saying, yeah, I need that right now. Like, no one is saying I need extraction shooters. Like, so what is this trend? Like, oh man, I'm so tired of the trends. Like, these trends, like, everything had to be a battle royale. Everything had to be like an Among Us type, whatever. Everything has to be like this four player co-op looter shooter shit. Now we have this extraction. Like, I don't, what is this? This is so silly to me.
I mean, it's
it's one of those things where business and being able to make profit conflicts with creativity, right? Because from an investment perspective, they want to make quote unquote safe bets.
Yeah, but these businesses ain't been businessing, bro. Like, it hasn't been working. So what the fuck?
But you also gotta realize that most of the business heads who are like in those positions don't lack foresight. I don't know how else to say it. Like, they just
don't. You're not wrong at all.
They just lack the foresight to kind of be ahead of the curve and like know, like, yeah, look, I know this isn't big now, but this got a lot of big potential and believing in stuff like that. And you know,
like, unless you're like one of the first ones out the gate, or you're an innovator. Like, we all shit on Fortnite, right? We all love to shit on Fortnite, whatever, whether we like it or not. Battle Royales weren't that popular at the time. Don't get me wrong, they were like on the come up. You had like the, what was it, H1Z1 or whatever, I don't know what the fuck it was called. PUBG. We had all these other ones that were kind of popular, but Fortnite came out and just blew that shit out the water, right? Like, everything has to have a Battle Royale now. Ever since that shit dropped, Apex came out, Warzone, right? Halo wants to do it, but they never did it for some reason. So unless you're a game like that where you push the envelope, nobody gives a fuck. I'm sorry. Like, and then I guess COD was another one, right? That did it a decade ago, where COD made that trend of every game gotta be a first person shooter now. Every game has to be a first person game now, right? So. But the thing is, back then, I don't know. It was different back then because you still had companies taking risks. You still had Sony making, like, you know, Uncharted, Sly Cooper games were still coming out back then. We had, like, Ratchet & Clank was still, you know. I mean, don't get me wrong, Ratchet & Clank still exists. But you had Bloodborne, right? You had, what was that game that they made that flopped? The Order, whatever, something. I don't know what the fucking
rest of the Order, 1886?
Like, yeah, the tech demo, yeah.
yeah,
I want to play that, man.
You had games, you had like Horizon, right? You had a lot of, you still had a lot of shit. So I don't know, man. We're in this era where even Sony is going down this fucking trend. Like, it's annoying. Like, fuck a marathon. I give zero fucks about this game. Sorry if I offend anybody. I give zero fucks about a marathon. There's nothing. As soon as I heard it's an extraction shooter, I don't care how cool it is, I'm just not interested. When it comes out, and I see that it's fun and I hear that it's cool, then I might buy it. Like, Helldivers 2, I was like, yeah, I liked Helldivers 1, but I'm not in a rush to buy Helldivers 2. But what got me, you know what I'm saying? Like, what made me interested was like, oh shit, everybody's talking about it. Oh shit, this game looks like jokes. All right, this game looks fun. But like I said in the beginning, no one's fucking clamoring for a damn Extraction. Come on. What are you doing? Unless you're making it in a way where it's different from everything else and it's innovative and it's cool as fuck, sure, but fuck, what's that shit, man? Give me my Bloodborne, bro. Give me Bloodborne. Give me Ghost of Tsushima 2. Give me, like, something that I actually... I guess it's more personal, right? Obviously, that's subjective. Give me something that I give a fuck about.
Yeah.
I want Ghost of Tsushima 2. That's what I want. That shit was fire. And that shit came out of nowhere.
Like, man, that game is so beautiful. I would love to replay that game on my...
I can't wait for the PC version, bro.
Upcoming... Yeah, the PC version on my upcoming... 4K OLED that I'm about to buy in a couple of weeks.
Like, damn, bro.
I'm salivating right now, bro. Kiss my
ass. Like, obviously, you know, we got a bunch of drones out there in the video gaming world now that just they'll just eat up whatever the fuck these corporations feed them. And fuck y'all. Like, I'm not gonna have them try to sell me on a fucking another Extraction shooter. Another four-player looter shooter. Give me something else. Give me something else. And I love, you know what the weird part is? I love some of these types of, I love Borderlands, right? I liked Destiny in the beginning. I liked, what the fuck is the game that was in beta? The third-person Nexon game that we played? The Last Descendant or The First Descendant? Something like
the
that.
The First Descendant? Yeah. That's like, about to drop. Yeah, that game was mad fun, actually.
Yeah, like shit like that. Like, it's cool. Like, it's fun. I like the games, but I'm not out here begging for shit like that. You know what I mean? Yeah, man, I need another one of those. But whatever.
Like, those games would already have to be godlike for me to be like, exactly. All right, let me go ahead and jump in. Because it's like, I don't know if, I don't know what I want until I see it. You know what I mean? Like, it's like one of those things of just like, but I don't want, you know, like it's... Like, the game's gotta have the attitude, I'm gonna give you what you need, not what you want. You know, and kind of have that mindset about it. And then, you know, like, for Helldivers 2, that shit was not on my radar. Because it looked cool, because, like, I enjoyed it. I was like, oh, this is kind of like a Starship Troopers game. But in the past, any Starship Troopers-type game was just not it, well, right? So,
the good thing about that game, right? Helldivers 1 was really good. That's the main reason why I was in it, right? Like,
yeah, I had no clue what Helldivers 1... Yeah, I never played it.
So that's the only reason why I was like, yeah, it's on my radar, but I was like, I'm not gonna get it yet, right? I was gonna wait on it. Then y'all motherfuckers, man. Like, freak gonna go and get fucking different. Y'all motherfuckers. Y'all bad, bro. Y'all are bad influences.
We are indeed. But I think the thing is too, like, it's like, man, a lot of this is more reactionary, right? Like, it's all of these publishers being reactionary to things, right? Mm-hmm, like, mm-hmm. They're seeing what's popular and then like, oh we can do that.
Okay.
And that's not the way to go about these. These things are like, these are viral, kind of like just stroke of luck, you know, strike of lightning. It happens once, it may happen twice, especially during the pandemic. We had like Fall Guys and Among Us that kind of like blew up, you know, like these are things like, yeah, you can make these games, but that doesn't necessarily mean that people are going to want to stop playing the ones that are already out there. Because like, what if people want an extraction shooter, what's deterring them from playing Tarkov, right?
You know what, I'm going to play devil's advocate, because I actually feel like we're in an era where actually I don't think type of game even fucking matters anymore, right? Because we live in such a volatile era, such a viral era, right? Mm-hmm. Where as soon as something goes viral, or as soon as everyone's like on top of something, it's like you're obligated to play it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like Power World was a great example. Like Power World came out, I didn't really give a fuck. But then everyone's talking about it. It actually looks good. I was like, oh shit, wait a minute. Obviously, when you hear everybody talk about it, you look more into it. And if it looks good, then you're like, okay, cool, I'll try this. Like Helldivers 2, motherfucker, how many people do you think actually cared about Helldivers 2 until it was all over Twitter, all over the place? I don't think it was many.
Not a lot.
I really don't think it was many. Like, so now that I'm thinking about it, I feel like people are just going to be drones, just be attracted to whatever is hype at the moment. And that's, I mean, obviously that's been the case. Like you said, Fall Guys, Among Us, mm-hmm. right? Like,
well, Here's the other thing. How can you be safe when you're like, okay, you see something that's popular and you're like, okay, let's make a game on it, right? But it's not like you can release a game within a year. You know what I mean? It's not like the old days.
Exactly. Yeah.
So you're going to spend 4 years developing the game, and then by the time that game comes out, the fad has been done with.
Yeah, that's so, what I said. Marathon coming out. When was that supposed to come out? This summer, right? Or something like that?
Yeah.
I think it was supposed to come out this summer, and that is delayed to the next year. Who the fuck is going to care?
Like, no one.
I don't know. Maybe Helldivers 2 will kind of, you know, boost the interest in that game, since it's probably, you know, it's kind of similar. It's an extraction shooter, right?
But yeah, so, but the thing is, if I'm Sony, right, and Helldivers 2 comes out, why would I reinvest into Bungie? I would just reinvest in the guys who are doing well right now.
Like, because Helldivers 2 is not $60, $70. Right?
It don't matter.
And Helldivers 2 doesn't have the pedigree of a Bungie game, right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
man, I guess, man. I just don't think.
There are millions of people that are going to buy the game because it's Bungie. And they're going to, listen, you already know.
But they
know
don't
what
even
the
have the same people that
be.
Work there. Like,
it doesn't matter.
Literally,
nobody, no one knows that but us. Nobody knows that.
Right.
The majority of people do not know that or care. So they're going to, the marketing is going to be Marathon, the game brought to you by the devs that made Bungie, by the studio that made you, that made Halo, the studio that made Destiny. That's what the marketing is going to be. And people are going to eat that shit up. So, like, I don't know, man. It's like, I hate the corporate side of shit, bro. It sucks so bad. But whatever.
Yeah, that's what's.
But like, we all know why they do these things, but it still fucking sucks.
Look at the Suicide Squad Defense Force, right? They're still defending that ish, even though.
Bro. I've seen somebody from the crazy things
Rocksteady
about that.
Group on. Are already long gone, so they're still buying those games.
Neckbeard motherfuckers want to fucking shit on Stellar Blade. Get the fuck out of here, bro. Like, get out of here. Go somewhere. You want to shit on Stellar Blade? You want to shit on unique games? Like I think the Princess Peach game is the most unique game to come out.
Yo, that Princess Peach. I'm so excited to play that Princess Peach game. You have no idea. I'm streaming
that
shit day one.
And Dragon's Dogma to me, like, don't get me wrong, I'm going to love the fuck out of FF7 Rebirth, bro. I think that's going to be my game of the year, most likely, right?
Mm-hmm.
But Dragon's Dogma and Stellar Blade look unique enough for me that I care more about those games right now. Because Final Fantasy VII, like, I know I'm going to play that game, right? Like,
and you know you're going to enjoy it.
Who's going to play that game? Yeah,
yeah, you know, like, you know you're going to enjoy it. You're going to play it. And
so,
then,
as I'm getting older, I care more about the games that I didn't expect to look good. I didn't. Stellar Blade came out of nowhere, right? We didn't know shit. Devs are new. Game looks great. Dragon's Dogma 2, when they announced it, I didn't expect it, right? And
I don't think anybody did.
They look great. Like, so I don't know, man. I'm more excited for new IPs nowadays than I am for anything else. New IPs that look good. Not the 7th installment or the 18th installment in the fucking franchise that's been around since I was a kid. Even though, don't get me wrong, I love those games, but I'm more excited for new shit.
Oh, the 13th remake of another title, right?
Yeah, Last of Us. Sorry.
Hey, man, there's going to be part 3 coming out eventually. Hey,
part
3 coming out, and then the remaster of part 3, and then part 3 PC.
Look, none of the Last of Us. Okay, I'm going to be sure. None of the Last of Us devs are ever going to. We're never going to interview those motherfuckers.
Yo, yeah, I'm not even talking about the devs. I'm talking about the fans. Those motherfuckers are going to be, fuck these guys.
But the thing is, I used to be
I love the first game. I love the first game, but I still think it was overrated.
We've seen the evidence follow. The loss of your love for it is very apparent.
As
and they killed it for
game,
you.
As a video game, Last of Us is overrated. Sorry. Last of Us is overrated. Like, there's nothing you can tell me. And there's no argument that any Last of Us fan can make that'll make me think otherwise. Like, as a video game, as a straight-up video game, Last of Us is overrated. Sorry.
I can't wait till we come full circle and we get The Last of Us based on the HBO series video game.
That would be better than The Last of Us 2.
Mm-hmm. At least until season 2 comes out, right?
True. I don't know if I was waiting for that.
Man,
it's gonna be his
That's
favorite
be
thing,
week, bro. I'm gonna be rubbing my hand, just like fucking with the Super Freak smug. By the way, if you guys don't know, Super Freak has like the biggest smug look on his face. Like, you guys have no idea. It's just so, like, I could sense smugness, and he's like that's the literal definition. If we put it in the dictionary, I just want to see a photo of his smug face. Like that's how smug I'm gonna be when they preview that season two. But watch them change everything, right? And then look, I'm not even gonna get into it, bro. That's